This week on WealthTrack, while other investors flee stocks for the comfort of bonds, our great investor is embracing them. Wintergreen Fund's David Winters on why he loves stocks is next on Consuelo Mack WealthTrack. Winters, who has been named one of the world's greatest investors by Smart Money magazine, is not hedging his bets right now. His Wintergreen Fund is about 90% invested in stocks, two-thirds of which are foreign-based companies. Winters believes the global economy is in the midst of profound shifts with huge ramifications for investors. I asked him what has changed.
The power is shifting from the Western world to the Far East. And, you know, we're still very relevant, but the cutting edge of wealth creation is happening in Asia. And that's very different from the world in which I grew up in and that most of us have grown up in.
Now, this change, it's been coming along for a number of years, but you tell me it's accelerated through the financial crisis. What changed during the financial crisis that really has accelerated this shift in economic power?
Well, you've had the West go down, and you've had asset values collapse, and a lot of debt. You've had an ongoing debt crisis, and you've had continued prosperity in Asia. So the differential has widened, and so you have prosperity in Asia generally, and the West is mired in a severe recession and debt liquidation. And so, you know, as Wayne Gretzky would say, you got to skate to where the puck is, and the puck is increasingly outside of North America.
So how lasting do you think this shift is going to be? And this scary question from, a U.S. citizen's point of view, is the gap going to keep widening between us and them, or do you see us coming up and gaining some momentum?
Well, I think the West is going to come back. I think there will be an economic recovery. I think things will get better. Tomorrow will be a brighter day. But, you know, there's some real issues about how fast we can grow.
Right.
And you know, what's so exciting about Asia is you have 3 billion people, give or take, who want everything that we have. And they're willing to work really hard to get it. So part of our job at Wintergreen is to figure out what can we invest in that capitalizes on this economic tectonic shift.
So is that a key factor that when you're looking at businesses to invest in, because you do invest in companies as businesses, not
right.
trading stocks, is that a key factor in whether or not you invest with a company?
It's absolutely an important factor. It doesn't mean that we won't invest in a company in Europe or the US or Canada, but it's great to have some sort of global exposure. You know, first of all, to have multi-currency diversification and free cash flow really reduces your risk and creates more upside.
So the multi-currency aspect of that, how important is that?
Well, the dollar, the US dollar, has got problems because, you know, we're borrowing a lot of money as a country. And so you really, as a dollar investor, and today almost everybody is in the US is super overweight the dollar, they need to diversify overseas. And so that's what we, you know, 5 years ago, we only were a third overseas. Today we're over two-thirds on a look-through basis.
So, you know, what about the alternative investments? I mean, don't you think, having been through what we've just been through in the last couple of years, that in fact that it's you're being less risky, that you're being smarter to more broadly diversify rather than being those risk assets that are called stocks?
Well, it depends on what stocks you own.
Right.
But if you own really good companies, we call it the trifecta, you own a company with good or improving economics, management that's working hopefully for the shareholders and a low price, you take the risk out. Stocks are going to go up and down. They always have. And this idea that you can take fluctuations out, it's hard. But ultimately, the richest people in the world, whether it be on the Forbes 400 list or whatever list, they all owned a business or a series of businesses. And the fact that people aren't interested in equities, you know, as a contrarian and as a value investor, mm-hmm. you can buy into big, liquid, really good companies at 50% discounts to asset value.
So give me a couple of examples, and I know if I look at some of your largest holdings, for instance, sure. what kind of exemplifies the kind of discounts and the value that you're talking about?
Well, just one that pops to mind is Anglo American is a mining company run by a woman named Cynthia Carroll. She's brilliant, and a geologist by background, and she's turned the company into a safety culture, an efficiency culture, and I think the stock's very cheap. And, I think there's a mineral rush going on. And if you see what's going on with China and other countries, there's this rush to secure long-term assets. BHP bid for potash. Potash is used in fertilizer. If you want to feed 3 billion people better, you got to have potash.
And I know Canadian Natural Resources has been another, long-term holding of yours. And so the attraction of that as well, is there a theme there?
Yes.
Yeah.
One of the problems is you've got all these people who want what we have.
Right.
There are not big pools of oil being found. I mean, there are little pools. There's lots of oil off of Brazil, but you got to drill really, really deep to get it. And CNQ has, Canadian Natural Resources, has these vast resources. And we think it trades at a discount to asset value, has great management, and it's cheap. And it's in Canada. And Canada is one of the best countries in the world. You've got rule of law, you've got a market system, we have a free trade agreement, and it's a wonderful place. I love Canada.
The Canadian currency, does that have something to do with it as well? The Canadian dollar, is that a way of diversifying out of the U.S. dollar?
Well, this again goes back to our original question about markets.
Right.
It wasn't that long ago that Canada had some serious problems. And so they addressed them over time. They paid down debt. They ran the country better. And what's happened? Their currency has gone to 98 cents. And some of it is our currency has gone down. But a lot of it has to do with how well Canada's been run. And also that they have all this oil and potash.
All the things that we need to run the world. Yeah.
And it's a free society.
So the rule of law, is that another factor that you look at before you invest in a company?
Yeah. Yes. We really want to be invested in a country that has a backdrop of respect for laws with respect to shareholders. And that, it's your money, you've invested it, whatever your nationality, we're going to treat you fairly.